Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, Ranking Member Murray, members of the committee. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to discuss briefly with you today the role of the National Institutes of Health in research addressing COVID-19. And as you indicated, Mr. Chairman, I will, during the question period and alluding to in the presentation, address some of the issues regarding schools. The NIAID-NIH strategic plan for COVID research involves four major components. The first is to improve the fundamental knowledge of understanding of the biology of the virus and the immune response to the virus in order to better inform us in the development of diagnostics, therapeutics, and vaccines. Some of the work that has come out of that program right now informs very greatly how we will address vaccine development, particularly understanding the conformation of the components of the virus that induce an appropriate immune response. In addition, we will develop and are developing animal models. Apropos of what you mentioned about children in school, we have a program called HEROES, which is Human Epidemiology and Response to SARS Coronavirus, which is determining the incidence and transmissibility among children, a very important issue when you talk about opening schools and the impact that might have. In addition, the development of diagnostics, point of care, sensitive and specific diagnostics under the RADx program, including the RADx up for underserved populations. Third, to characterize and test therapeutics. You mentioned the importance of this as we open up schools. There are a number of programs, very active, that have already shown efficacy or not in some drugs, as well as a number of clinical trials that are ongoing. One in particular was the first randomized placebo-controlled trial showing that the drug remdesivir diminishes by about 32% the time it takes to get to recovery in people with advanced disease pulmonary involvement. In addition, we have another study combining this with an anti-inflammatory agent. Next, we have vaccines. As several have mentioned, it's extremely important to have safe and effective vaccines available for everyone in this country, as well as globally. In that regard, we put together, myself and some of my colleagues, and published in Science magazine a few weeks ago, what we call a strategic approach to coronavirus 19 vaccine research and development. It's not a comprehensive plan about every aspect of vaccine, but it is a strong plan regarding the research and development pathway. And what we have done in this is that we have what's called a harmonized effect, because we know there are many vaccines that are in trial now at various stages. And what we did, and the federal government, thanks to the generosity of the Congress, has put a considerable amount of money in order to harmonize the trials of multiple candidates from different companies so that we have common endpoints, common data and safety monitoring board, and common immunological parameters that are being funded and are being pursued. In addition, there are a number of different platforms that are being pursued so that we don't have all our eggs in one basket. As you know, one of those is right now getting ready as we approach next month of going into phase three trials, and others will be staggered along the way in the middle of the summer, end of the summer, early on. There is no guarantee, and anyone who's been involved in vaccinology will tell you, that we will have a safe and effective vaccine, but we are cautiously optimistic, looking at animal data and the early preliminary data, that we will at least know the extent of efficacy sometime in the winter and early part of next year. Again, working with the companies and the investment made by this Congress, hopefully there will be doses available by the beginning of next year. These are the things that we feel aspirationally hopeful about, and we will continue to pursue this. I'll stop there, Mr. Chairman, and be happy to answer questions later.